Hello and welcome to the new video of Easy Tutorials. Today in this video you will see how to make a travel website template using HTML, CSS and Bootstrap. Here you can see one demo website that I will create in this video. First of all, I have one logo here in the left side, and in the right side you can see there is one button, and after that there is a search box where people can search different city or any country. In the background there is a full screen image. After scrolling, you can see there is one featured destination section where you can see the featured packages, their price and location, ratings and image. Next we have travel gallery, where you can see I have added four different images, and you can see this effect, zoom effect, when I will take cursor over this image. Next we have this offer section where you can see some offer text and one button. Next we have users review, where I have added three different reviews and it's looking very nice. At the bottom you can see there is a footer area with four different columns, one logo, some information, some useful links, social media links and copyright text also. This website template is completely responsive. Let me change the screen size so that you can see this website is looking perfect on a small screen also. You will learn to create this complete template in this video using HTML, CSS and Bootstrap. So now let's start this tutorial. First of all, you can see I have one folder, and in this folder I have another folder with so many images that I will be using on this website. So let's come back to this folder, and here we will create the first file, that is HTML file. So I am writing index.html. Simply open this file with any text editor. I am using brackets editor. So let me zoom it so that you can see this page clearly. First I am writing some basic HTML code like HTML open and close. Then head, open close. In this head I will add one title. So the title is Travel Website Easy Tutorials. After this head we will write body, open and close. Let's come back to the folder again, and here we will create another file, that is CSS file. So I am writing as style.css, and just open this file with text editor. First we will write star, margin 0 and padding 0. That will be applied for all the elements. Next we will link this CSS file with HTML. For that I am writing link rel styleset href and the file name, that is style.css. After that I'll write one more code for making the page responsive, that is meta name viewport content is equal to width is equal to device width, and initial scale will be 1.0. After adding this, we have to add one Bootstrap link. For that, I'll duplicate this line of code. And just remove this one. And let's go to the Google. On Google, I'll search for Bootstrap CDN. Open this first link. And from this website, we will use this URL and add it here in the href. That's it. So after linking the Bootstrap, just come to the body, and first we'll create one section, and I'm writing the class name header. In the header I am creating one more div, and the class name is container, that is a Bootstrap class that will add some space from left and right. After that, copy this class name header and come to the CSS file. For this header we will write the height, so height will be 100%. And now we'll add some background image. So I am using one linear gradient color on this image. After that, image folder name and slash image file name. That is banner1.jpg. Let's save these changes and come to the web page. Now you can see this background image on this web page, but it is not aligned properly. So we have to write background size cover, background position, center. We can use background attachment fixed. That's it. After refreshing this page, you can see this image is aligned properly on the entire screen. Now we'll come to this container and first we'll add one logo. For that I'm using img source and the file name. After refreshing this page, you can see this logo over here, but it is too big. So simply I'll use this class name header, add it here, and after that I'm writing img for this logo. So width will be 170 pixel, float left. Next I'll add one button and the type is button, and I'm writing one class name login btn, and the button text is login. Let's copy this class name login btn and come to the css file, add it here. After that I'm writing width 100 pixel, padding 8 pixel 0, outline will be none. Next I'm writing border 2 pixel solid white color, border radius will be 50 pixel, and background I'm using transparent. So the button text will be white, so I'm using color white. So after refreshing, you can see this logo and button over here. Next I have to add float right. Now this button is aligned in the right side. Next I have to add some space from the top. So in header I am adding padding top 20 pixel. Now you can see some space from the top. So after this button here, we'll create the title. So I am using h1, and one title I am writing travel across the globe, and in the next line I am adding some text in p tag. Subscribe Easy Tutorials YouTube channel. After refreshing this page, you can see these text over here. So now we'll add text align center in this header, and color will be white. So now you can see these text are aligned in the center and its color is white. Next I'll copy this class name here, and after that I'm using h1. So for this h1, padding top will be 200 pixel and padding bottom will be 0. Let's write font size 55 pixel, now you can see some space from the top. Next I'll copy it again, and after that I'm writing p, and for this p margin is 18 pixel 0 pixel. Now you can see a space around this p text. Next we'll add one search box. For that I'm using div class input group, and one input field here. Input type will be text, and class name I am using form control. These are the Bootstrap class. So the placeholder is search country or city. Next, I am using one more div, and the class name is input group append. And in this field, I am adding button. So I am writing one class name for this button, input group text and btn, and the button text is search, and this button type will be submit. After refreshing this page, you can see a full width of search box and one search button. Next, we will copy this class name input group and come to the CSS file. So for this input group, I am writing width 90%, and the maximum width will be 500 pixel. Border radius will be 30 pixel and background white. Margin padding. So now you can see a small width for this search box. Next, we'll copy this class name for form control, add it here. And for this form control, I'm writing border. Border radius, margin, and box shadow none. This border radius I'll make 30 pixel. So now you can see round border for this search box. Next, I'll copy this class name for this button. So simply add it here, and for this one I am writing width 100 pixel. Background image linear gradient color. Border 0. Color will be white. And padding, then border radius 30 pixel, box shadow will be none. So after refreshing this page, you can see this attractive search form and button. Next, I want to increase some space from top, so I'm making it 230 pixel. So it is looking like this one. Let me increase it, so I am changing it to 260 pixel. And now you can see a good space from the top. So after completing the header section, we will create the next section, and I am creating one class name features. So first we will write one title in h1 tag. The title is featured destinations. So after refreshing this page, you can see this title at the bottom. Let's copy this class name features and come to the CSS file. First we'll write one comment. After that I'm adding this class name over here. For this one I'm writing padding 100 pixel from top and bottom and 0 from left and right. Next I'm writing h1. So for this h1 text align will be center and padding bottom will be 30 pixel. Now you can see good space around this text. After this title we'll create one container. First we'll write div and class name is container. Next we have to create different column. For that I am using one row, and in this row there will be three different columns. So I am creating a column called md4 because we have option to use 12 grid, so I am using 4 grid in the first column. Like this I have created three different column, and now just come to the first column. So here we'll create one more div and I'm writing one class name feature box. In this feature box I'll create one more div and the class name is feature img. And this box will contain image, so I am using img source and the file name. So after refreshing this page you can see this image for the first column. So let's copy this class name feature img and for this one I'll write here img. So the width will be 100%. Now it is aligned properly. After this image we'll create one more div and the class name is price. So this div will contain the price of this package. So I'm using p tag to add the price, so I'm adding $78. Now you can see this price just below this image. Next we'll create one more div and the class name is rating. Okay, in this rating we'll add the star icons. So first we'll go to the Google and search for font awesome CDN. Simply open the first website and copy this URL. Just come to the HTML file in the head, just duplicate this one and replace this href. That's it. So after this CDN link, just come to the Google again and type font awesome icons. So open this official website of font awesome and here you can search any icon that you want to use on website. So first I am searching for rating. So here you can see I got some icons, so just select this one and copy this one line of code and add it here. We can remove this one, it is not required. Simply duplicate it to create multiple icons. So just come back to this page and search again. So here you can see there is one more option for half star. So now I'll copy this one. So right now you can see total 4.5 star. So after refreshing this page you can see this 4.5 star over this web page. Next I will change this one. I'll make it O And now it is 3.5 star. Next, we'll copy this class name for price and come to the CSS file. So first we'll write the width. It will be 50 pixel and height. Next, background and color will be white, and font weight and border radius will be 50%. Now you can see this price box here. It is a round shape. Let's add padding. And box shadow. Next, we'll copy this class name feature img. And here we'll write position relative, and for this price we'll write position absolute. Next, we'll add left 20 pixel and bottom minus 25 pixel. Let me change this one 50 pixel. Yes, it is moving downward. So for now we'll copy this class name rating and come to the CSS file. Here I'm writing padding float right. Background, it will be white. Bottom, minus 1 pixel. Right, 0. And position, absolute. Now you can see a star icon in the right side. For this price, I am changing the bottom, minus 25 pixel again. Now it is aligned properly. Next, I'll copy this one, add it here, and after that I'm writing FA. So for these icons we'll write font size and color. Now you can see colorful star icon. After this feature img, will add some text. So I'm using div class feature details. So first we'll write one title in h4. Next we'll add some text in p tag. Subscribe Easy Tutorials YouTube channel to watch more videos on website development, UI designing, digital marketing. Press the bell icon to get immediate notification of new videos. Now you can see this title and small description just below this image. Next, we have to add some space from the top. So just copy this one, feature details, add it here. So for this one, I'm writing padding 20 pixel. Text align justify. Let's copy it again Then I'm writing H4. Font weight 600. Margin top 20 pixel. Now you can see proper space from the top. After these text, we'll add some other information, that is icons and text. So I'm using div and span. Let's copy this code for the icon, add it here, and we'll change the icon name. It is map maker. And the second one is sun, and the third one is moon. After refreshing this page, you can see three different icons here. So for each icon, we'll write some text. Now you can see icon and their text. Next we'll copy it again, and after that I'm writing .fa, and for this one margin right, it will be 5 pixel. So after completing the first column, we'll copy all the content from the first column and we'll add it into the second one. And for the third one also. Now you can see the three columns for this feature. Let's change the image. So now you can see three different images for all the columns. Let's copy this class name and add it here. And for this one, I'm writing box shadow. After that, margin bottom. So after completing the feature section, we'll create the another one. So first we'll create section and one class name, gallery. Then we'll write one title in H1. So the title is traveling gallery. After refreshing this page, you can see this title over here at the bottom. Next, we'll copy this class name gallery and come to the CSS file. And for this gallery, I'm writing padding 100 pixel from top and bottom and 0 from left and right. Next, I'm writing background. So I'm changing the background color here. It is a light gray color. Let's add div, class, and container. So again, we'll create the different columns. So I'm using row. And now I'm creating the first column. For that I'm using colmd3. So in this first column, first we'll add one image. And after this image, I'm writing one more title and I'm using H4. Now you can see this image and one title just below this image. Next, we'll create one class name over here in the first column. So class name is gallery box. I'll close it here just after this title. And simply copy this class name and come to the CSS file. First we'll write width 100%, border radius 10 pixel. Cursor pointer. Well, it is not working. Actually, I have to write img here. Okay, now you can see proper size for this image. Let's copy it again. And after that I'm writing hover transform scale 1.1, and here we'll add transition 1 second. So after refreshing this page, you can see this zoom effect when I will take cursor over this image. Next we'll copy this class name and add it here. For this one I'm writing h4, width will be 200 pixel, text align center, font weight 600. Next I'll copy this class name and add it here, and for this one I'm writing position relative. Margin bottom 30 pixel. Again coming to the h4, and for this one we'll write position absolute. Top 50%, left 50%. I can remove this one, and now you can see these text over here. Here we'll write color white and text shadow. Now you can see this text clearly. Let's add transform, translate, minus 50% and minus 50%. Actually, I have to remove this one. And here we'll write display block. Now you can see this text in the center. So for now we have to reduce the font size. So I'm writing font size 20 pixel. Now you can see proper alignment for this text and image. Now we'll copy the first column and just paste it to create the another one. I'm changing the image name, and this one is third column, and changing the image file name for third column, and this one is for fourth column. So now you can see four different images and text. So after creating the travel gallery section, we'll create the another one. So first we'll write section and one class name. So the class name is banner. Just copy this class name and come to the CSS file. First we will write height for this banner section. So height will be 80%. Let's add background image. Next I am adding background position center. And background size cover. And background attachment, it will be fixed. So after refreshing this page, you can see this background image for the next section. Now we'll create one more div here and the class name is banner highlights. And let's add one more class name, and here I'm writing class name container. Now we have to create two different columns. For that I'm using div class row, and we'll create the first column. So I'm using columnMD8. So this will be the big column, and the second one is columnMD4, the small column. So in the first column, we'll add some text. I'm using H2. Get 30% on top destinations. And some small text also. After refreshing this page, you can see these text in this section. So let's copy this class name and add it into the CSS file. First we'll write padding 70 pixel and 0, background. Next I'm writing text align center and the color is white. So now you can see white color text and background a little dark color. Next we'll add padding in banner. So I'm writing padding top 10%. We have to increase it, so I'm making it as 12%. A little bit more, I'm making it as 14%. Now it's looking good. Now we'll come to the second column, and here we'll create one button. So I'm using button type button, and button text is book now. Let's add one class name here. So I'm writing the class name BookingBTN. So let's copy this class name BookingBTN, add it here. And after that, I'll come to the top. And from here, I'll copy the entire code and just paste it here. We can change this width 120 pixel. And this float I will remove. That's it. So after refreshing this page, you can see this button here. Now you can see we have to add some space from the top. So what I will write, margin top 20 pixel. Now you can see a good space for this button. and it is looking very good for the full screen also and a small screen. So after completing the offer section, we'll create the another one. So first we'll write the section and one class name. So class name I'm using users feedback. So first we'll write one title in h1. So the title is users review. Now you can see this title over this page just at bottom. Simply copy this class name and come to the CSS file. Here I am writing padding. Now you can see some space around this text. After this text, we'll create one div and the class name is container to add some space from left and right. Next, we'll create some column. For that I'm using div class row. And in this row, I'm creating the first column with column D4. Simply duplicate it to create the another column. In the first column, I'm using one more div and the class name is user review. So let's add some text in this box. So simply I will copy from here. And add it here. That's it. So after refreshing this page, you can see this review text in the first column. Next, we'll add some title in h5 tag. I'm writing one name. And one more text. For that, I'm using small. So now you can see this name and some text here. Next, we'll copy this class name user review and come to the CSS file. First, we'll write text align center. Box shadow. Now you can see the box shadow and these texts are aligned in the center. Simply copy it again and after that I am writing P. And for this P I am writing padding 50 pixels from top and 10 pixels from other sides. Now we'll come to the user review and here we'll write padding bottom 50 pixel. So here you can see some space from the bottom. So after these text, here we'll add one image. So I'm using img and the source and file name. Simply copy this class name and come to the CSS file, add it here. Then I'm writing img. And for this one, width will be 60 pixel and height 60 pixel. Border radius 50%. Position relative. Margin. There is something wrong. I have to change the class name. Just copy this one and replace this class name in CSS file. That's it. So after refreshing this page, you can see this a small image here. for this review box. Next, I'll copy it again. And after that, I'll write before. So for this one, we'll write content. Backslash 201D. Display will be block, position absolute. So now you can see this is a small quote icon here. Let me increase the font size. So I'm writing font size 100 pixel and some color. Font family. Now you can see this icon over here. Now we have to move it in the center. So for that I'm writing left 44% and top minus 20 pixel. So now it is aligned properly in this box. So simply I will copy the entire thing from the first column and paste it here to create the second column. Now I'm pasting it into the third column. Simply change the image. That's it. So now you can see three different user review. So after creating the review section, we'll create the next section. So first we'll write section and class name, it is footer. Let's add one more class name, container. Next, we have to create some column. For that, I'm using div class row. And again, we have to create four column. So what I'll write, div class column D3, because we have to create four column. So simply duplicate it to create four different columns. And coming to the first column, here we'll add one image. So I'm writing img source and the file name. Here we'll add one class name, that is footer logo. So right now this logo is not visible because it is in white color. So what I'll do, I'll just copy this class name footer and come to this CSS file. First we'll write padding 100 from top and bottom and 20 from left and right, and some linear gradient color for background. So for that I'm using background image, linear gradient and two different color. Let's add color white. So after refreshing this page, you can see this background color and this logo. Let's copy this class name footer logo and come to the CSS file. First we'll write width 150 pixel, margin top 15 pixel, margin bottom 15 pixel. Now you can see a small logo. After this logo, we'll add some text. So simply I will copy some text from this web page. From here I can copy and just add it below this image. So here you can see this text just below this logo in the footer. Next I am coming to the second column. First we'll write one title in H4. So the title is features. Let's add some text in p tag, deals and offers. Simply duplicate it to create the different text. So the second text is customer reviews and the third one is cancellation policy. Now you can see this content in the second column. Let's copy this class name, add it here, and after that I'm writing h4, and for this one text align left, margin top 15 pixel, margin bottom 25 pixel. Let's copy it again and we'll change it to p, and for this p font size it will be 12 pixel. Text align justify, padding right 35 pixel. So now you can see these text are justify for the first column. Simply copy everything and paste it into the second column. Just replace this text. So I am writing here quick contact. Next we'll copy the code for this icon, just add it here. And after this icon we'll write some text. So here I'm writing one demo phone number. And just change this icon also. This is phone square. Simply duplicate it. So the second one is envelope. And the third one is home icon. Here we'll write one demo email ID. And for third one we'll write some demo address. So now you can see three different columns in the footer. Simply I'll copy these content and paste it into the fourth column, and here we'll change the title, that is follow us on. Next we have to change the icons. So first one is Facebook official, and here text will write Facebook. Now the second icon, it is a YouTube, and text also YouTube. Now the third icon Twitter, and text also Twitter. So after refreshing this page you can see four different columns. Next we'll copy this one, and after that we'll write dot row and dot fa for this icons. For this icons we are writing padding right 20 pixel, font size 15 pixel. So now you can see a space between this icon and text. Oh, there is something wrong with this icon envelope. Now you can see all these icons are correct. After that we'll create one horizontal line. For that here we'll add HR. So here you can see horizontal line in dark color. It is not clearly visible, so we'll change the color. So just copy this one and write it here, HR margin top 10 pixel and background this light gray color. So now you can see this horizontal line clearly. Next we'll add copyright text in p tag, and here I am writing one class name also, copyright. And the text is made with, and one heart icon. Here we'll use one icon, so simply copy and paste it, and we'll change the icon name heart. That's it. And after that we'll write why easy tutorials. Simply save these changes and refresh the web page. Now you can see these text in the left side of this web page. Just copy this class name for this icon, add it here, and for this one we'll write margin and color. Just copy it again, and here we'll change copyright, and for this one text align will be center. So after refreshing this page, you can see this text in the center and red color for this icon. Next we'll change the padding. So here we'll write 20 pixel. So now you can see a less space in the bottom. Even we can reduce. So we'll make it 15 pixel. Now it is looking perfect. So finally we have created all these sections, and now we'll change the width of this web page so that you can see how it is looking on small device. So it is looking perfect. Just you can see we have to add some space here for this search box. So there is something wrong here. Let me check. Yes, for this input group it is 90% width. So here we'll add important. That's it. So after refreshing this page, you can see this one is also fixed. So now you can see this website is completely responsive for large screen device and a small screen device also. So like this, you can easily create this type of attractive web pages, attractive website using HTML, CSS and Bootstrap. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section, and if you have any difficulties while creating this website, you can ask me for the source code in the comment section. I hope this video was helpful for you. Please like this video and share this video on social media with your friends. Thank you so much for watching.